evolution of technology. How have we evolved in technology, and how does this change affect us?
Technology has continuously been at the forefront of human education from the days of carving figures on walls, especially in schools. The use of technology keeps growing greater and greater every day. In the colonial years, wooden panels with written lessons on them, known as hornbooks, were accustomed to teaching children how to read and write. Then, over 200 years later, in 1870, technology advanced to incorporate the lantern slides, a very primitive version of a projector that showed a series of pictures written on glass plates that were then projected onto a screen that we incorporated into schools as a new way of teaching. Ever since then, it was clear to see that students were hungry for additional academic advancements. Then came into play the radio in the 1920s, the typewriter in the 1930s, the projector also in the 1930s, the ballpoint pen in the 1940s, headphones in the 1950s, videotapes in 1951, photocopier in 1959, handheld calculator in 1972, which led to the production of more products since the everyday person was now able to calculate numbers faster and more effectively. Then came the Scantron testing system, which made it easier for your teachers to grade your work. That also came out in 1972. Everyday computers in 1980s and non-desktop computers in 1981. That weighed 24 pounds and was $1,795, which was the turning point in technology and children's education. You can also see technology evolve throughout everyday life advancements, like robots in 10,000 BC and hand washing machines in 1206, phones in 1876, cars and motorboats in 1886, motion pictures in 1888, planes in 1903, TVs in 1927, handheld phones in 1973. Whereas now we have technology like self-driving cars, designer babies, cloning technology, GMO foods, and touchscreen everything from the phones, computers, watches, even the cars we drive. Our generation is very codependent on our technology, which we can access anywhere between the Wi-Fi, cellular data, and hotspots at our fingertips. This uprise in new tech has caused us to lose basic human skills. Since our minds are weakened by lack of use, so the more we rely on the devices as we have, the less useful our brains become. And the grades go up while less information is actually being absorbed, making our generation look smarter while in actuality, it is mostly easy access, which can lead to us being more easily confused and frustrated. Technology also causes us to have a very short attention span that causes us to be easily distracted, either by our technology or just the events happening around us, which is why we get into so many more accidents than we did before. Technology has completely changed the way we communicate, since it helps people stay in touch that wouldn't otherwise be able to. But it changes everything when it comes to talking face-to-face, since we're so used to talking on the phone that we lose important communication skills. And the direct exposure to the blue light emitted by LED devices can really damage the retina of our eyes. The retinal damage that occurs from staring at the blue light, especially at night, can lead to molecular degeneration and damage your central vision. Tech is advancing, yet also getting worse due to greed. Industries use new styling to get you to trade in your old devices for newer, better models, long before those devices are fully worn out, by rendering the old devices obsolete. To ensure that you trade in your devices, manufacturers use inferior materials to deliberately shorten the lifespan of products. forcing consumers to purchase replacements. Manufacturers in the 1930s began to base their choice of materials on scientific tests by newly formed research that figured out exactly when each of the product's specific compounds would fail, since doing so increased the demand by 60%. For example, they came out with a PCU, the newer version of a PC computer system, which sounds great, yet the lifespan was only 4 to 5 years, whereas the 1997 model's PC had the life expectancy of up to 6 to 7 years. And by 2003, informed consumers expected only 2 years of use from the new systems. And today, the life expectancy of most PCs are even less. Sure, technology helps save trees with no need for paper, but it makes up for it. Since we are an advanced technological society that gets tired of things very quickly. Gil Slade, the author of Made to Break, writes, obsolete electronics, including last year's Palms, Blackberries, notebooks, printers, copiers, monitors, scanners, modems, hubs, docking ports, digital cameras, LCD projectors, zip drives, speakers, keyboards, mice, Game Boys, Walkman, CD players, VCRs, and DVD players, all awaiting disposal. And that was back in 2007. Just think about all the ways we have advanced from there, and how many obsolete devices we have added to the landfills over these past years. And our technology sales have gone up. In 2007, approximately 26.9 million television sets weighing over 910,600 tons were scrapped in the U.S. alone, while just last year selling over 281 million TV sets, with only 15% of those being recycled, meaning that 239 million of them were scrapped. And the number just keeps increasing along with the toxicity level in the landfills with every technological advancement. This will lead to insurmountable future storage problems. We do not have enough time, money, or space in the continental United States to create enough landfills to store and ignore America's growing pile of electronic trash. Not only does technology release toxicity into the dirt and atmosphere from being in landfills, but also the production of tech releases toxins, and most of the materials used to make these products happen to be rare earth metals that, when mining for, also release toxins into the atmosphere. The toxins that are now in the atmosphere affect everything. Since the toxins get into the water supply that animals drink, fish grow in, soil we use to grow plants, and not to mention in the air we breathe, making all the necessities we need to survive even poisonous. Granted, you may not immediately see effects of these poisons, but over time they can cause diseases like lung cancer, heart disease, malaria, hepatitis, and yellow fever. Diseases caused by pollution leads to the deaths of about 8.4 million people each year. Technology is simultaneously getting better and worse at the same time, since some of our older tech actually functions better today than the tech we have now. But our technology itself is much more advanced than what it used to be, and would be a suitable replacement if we got to use it at its full potential. Doing so would also solve our disposal problem. With how far we are in technology, we would only have to trade up every 10 to 20 years, limiting the amount of tech in landfills.
which could be solved completely if people would trade in their old devices to be recycled instead of just throwing them away. But either way, we'll still have to deal with the effects that the production of technology has on the Earth, our bodies, human interaction skills, and our education. We should also work on using our devices less to experience life the way it was intended to be, since more and more people would not be able to live without technology.